I like it. I feel like you got a lot of talent, you know?
Hey, before you guys take off, apparently last night was awesome. I wish I was there. That was quite a concert you guys put on, as they always do.
And you, my friend, sang your face off. Great job, wasn't it? Very much so.
Although you talked about it, I blacked out that entire time. Speaking of such a great performance, I was wondering if you could help Jared out with a little something.
Oh, okay.
Should I whisper
something?
Make sure they know it first.
No,
they might
not know the song.
Yeah, but they're musicians. They can do anything.
We're doing it anyway, guys. We're going to do something.
So, the band can really just, you don't even need to play. You can just
sing out.
Live this your love. Okay. With your voices.
Okay.
We're going to need one prop. Jared, you don't mind?
Yeah.
And I'm gonna need some help from all you guys out there. As some of you may know, it was Billy's birthday on Friday. 1, 2, 3.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Billy.
Howl!
too big for you, Jensen. It's too big.
Will I have a nickel? Will you be my Christian brother?
Ha ha ha!
Billy Nice.
They're on the highway,
her car's going across eight lanes. And they're like, what's wrong with her? And so Tim picks this up, and she's just like this.
Loud noises.
$5.
I think superheroes should just be good people. I read the script and became a massive fan of Deadpool.
Then he goes, "Oh, it's going to be something British." We were lucky enough to take our families to a beach for Thanksgiving,
and the kids loved it.
That our home base in Austin is
every time.
It's just very solid. And Austin is just a solid place. My wife grew up in snow. She grew up in Sun Valley, Idaho. So now she grew up. You just got usurped. So something played with something granular. Snow or that's okay. You got it.
Say something. I would be a skunk.
You would.
But like the Pepe Le Pew version.
Hey, what is French? Has two thumbs and plays a cartoon skunk.
No, I think you probably
Don't blame me. I have two. One was a guy in San Diego, the waiter. One guy came up, he must have been mid to late 20s, early 30s, big dude. It was probably like a surfer or something, big guy. And since he walked past, he had shoulder surgery. He was like, dude! And I think the first time I realized that we were going places was when Jensen got in trouble. So, there was a Weekly article that came out many years ago.
Oh, I was talking about this.
Hoping you can go blind sentence. And he gets a phone call saying, like, don't ever say we're going to cancel in season 5. And he, like, and Kripke got the same phone call. Because Kripke's like, you know, because Kripke. His whole joke was, like, seasons 1, 2, 3, 4, he was just like, guys, you gotta give me 5 seasons, you gotta give me 5 seasons. Because we thought we were gonna cancel it every single year. So, like, season 4 must have been when now things were looking up. Kripke did some article, and I think Jensen possibly said something similar. Who knows? You never know what that article means. But they both got kind of quoted as saying, like, they hope to go 5 seasons. They were both thinking, like, we hope we can pick up at least for season 5. And they both got phone calls from the head powers saying, quit saying you want to cancel the 5. Like, that's not what you meant. Like, wait, would you be mad if we said we wanted to cancel the 5? So I think we realized then that we're not just staying power. What's that? Not cool.
Isn't that cool?
I'm doing good.
Hey, Billy. Did you get a piece of your birthday cake? Yeah, I don't think so.
Jared?
Thank you. down the steps. I wanted to say, Jerry, you said in the vote panel earlier that comedy really wasn't, you were a little uncomfortable with that. But I wanted to say you do awesome comedy.
Well, due to the fact that he and I have been working together for so long and have gotten and had a lot of fight scenes, he and I work together very well. Our stunt coordinator, Lou Bolo, he's fantastic. Unfortunately, we don't give him much to do because he'll just show up and be like, all right, guys, what do you want to do? And we can coordinate something very quickly amongst the three of us. That being said, when there are new people that come on that might not have that kind of flight experience, it can be a little dicey. We're working with a couple of guys right now. One of them is a trained wrestler, the other one is a trained boxer. Because those guys know how to actually hit. They don't pull their punches or fake their punches, they land their punches. So when you're fake fighting with somebody who does nothing but real fight, it's a little nervous, I get a little nervous sometimes.
I think also what occurred to me was because I've recently viewed a fight scene that's going to be airing sometime in the near future. This fight scene took about a day to film. This fight scene lasts about 30 seconds. So, if you're filming a dialogue scene, if it's a dialogue scene between Jensen and I, between Jensen and me, and we are just speaking 5 pages to each other, it'll take 3 hours to film, but it'll last 4 minutes on camera. It flips for a fight scene. Because there's a wide angle, and then there's a close-up, and then there's a super close, and then there's a stunt double screen, and then there's this angle, because you have to focus really on where it's missing. So it takes so long logistically to film these fight scenes, which sucks. I think we have more time to film.
We do more, yeah.
Do more, do longer. Well, we'll see these blockings that our stunt coordinators and our stunt guys have blocked out. We're like, that's an amazing fight. We can cut half of it.
Yeah.
Which sucks.
There was a fight scene in the episode where Kane is sitting at the kitchen table shutting the corner. Give it up to Tim Robinson. And that fight scene took an entire day to shoot. It took a whole day, but one of the key elements of that fight scene was that the demon that I killed at the end, I stick him to the table with a knife, he was my stunt double. So he's a guy I've been working with for almost 14 years. So I trust him. He trusts me.
14 because of Dark Angel.
Yeah, he was my stunt double, Dark Angel. That we were able to really go at it a few times. The caveat is that he was my stunt double, so I didn't have one. So I had to do everything myself. Everything he was supposed to do, I had to do. There was nobody backing me up. So it was fun, but I guess it takes a long, long time to do it, which is why we don't do them all the time. But when we do them, I really enjoy it. I'd rather do a whole day of it. Fight sequence and a whole day of dialogue any day.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
act like there's no one here. What is your question?
So, y'all do a lot of visual effects. Effects that you can't see. So, my question is, what is it like to do that on such a regular basis?
That's a good question. The effects have changed incredibly over the past 11 seasons. For the first few years, we had a giant part of the stage as a green screen. So we used to shoot a bunch of stuff on a green screen, and that's where all the effects would get laid in. Now, because technology's advanced so much over the past decade, we don't even need that. So we can just be on a regular set, do a regular scene, and the effects people will come in and be like, so basically what's going to happen is the smoke is going to come in through the vent, and it's going to go here, it's going to go into the body, and they're going to scream, and it's going to get lights, and then this, and that, and yeah, that's what's going to happen. We're like, okay, thanks for the explanation, that's what we'll do. And so, once we understand kind of what they're going to do, then we just have to make believe.
And logistically, it's also, if you're doing a scene with someone who's not there, then it... You see what you reacted? Now, pretend I'm talking to you. Exactly. My point is that if you're doing a scene with something that's an X, because it's a monster that doesn't actually exist, and like, and you're scared, or if you're doing a scene with somebody that's an actor, and they say, how dare you, and you say, well, because I had to, and how dare you, then there's reaction, right? So, in conversation, there's like, I'm asking you a question, you're answering a question. If I look angry, you respond kind or humorous. Whereas responding to some of visual effects, okay, and now the car crashes. It's odd. You really have to commit to what you're doing. A scene that like Sam and Dean are together talking in a motel, and it's easy. He talks, I listen, I talk, he listens, we respond to each other. But if you're in front of a green screen, you're like, okay, and the monster's coming to get you. So it's all more difficult.
I really hope I see you do that job. He did do that once. It was during the French mistake. We were filming the French mistake. No, I'm not kidding. There was a bowl of blood that Balthazar was painting the sigil on to throw us through the window, right? And it was right there, and Sebastian, he had his name, he knew his name. And Jerry and I are standing right there, like next to the couch, and the bowl starts to slowly tip. And it tips slowly, very slowly. And then, Jerry's standing right there, all he had to do was go like this. That fast, it was. Instead, we both look at him, like, is he not going to say, why is he going to say it? And it topples, and he goes like this. Immediately he turns to me and goes, I always hoped I would react like that. Very peaceful. Thank you.
My season's probably 1-4 belt. It really became my belt afterwards. It is being auctioned off to the charity of Birthday Boys Choosing, so at some point in time today, don't miss the order of the car. Love you guys.
Again, thank you.